Hello everyone, today in this video we are going to discuss the landmark case of Mohammad Ahmad Khan versus Shah Bano Begum, which is also known as Triple Talaq case. Facts of the case are as follows. In 1932, Shah Bano was married to Mohammad Ahmad Khan, who was a renowned lawyer in Indore. They were the parents of 3 sons and 2 daughters. After 14 years of their marriage, Shah Bano's husband married another woman who was younger than him. In 1975, when Shah Bano age was of 62 years, she was disowned by her husband and was thrown out from her matrimonial home along with her children. In April 1978, she brought an appeal under Section 125 of CRPC in presence of the judicial magistrate of Indore, after when she was thrown away from her matrimonial home by her husband. Shah Bano filed this suit in 1978 because her husband has abandoned her from the maintenance of Rs. 200 per month which he guaranteed to give. In November 1978, he gave divorce to his wife Shah Bano by articulating or uttering triple talaq, and it was irrevocable. The argument or conflict between Shah Bano's children and her husband's other wife were vital reason or grounds on which divorce were relinquished and furnished. After he pronounced irrevocable triple talaq, he took a safeguard that since because of this divorce, she has been terminated to be her legal wife, and due to which he was not accountable to furnish her with maintenance or alimony. The local court directed Mohammad Ahmad Khan to furnish her Rs. 25 per month to Shah Bano in form of maintenance. Shah Bano in July 1908, apart from this, made a plea to High Court of Madhya Pradesh to alter the amount of maintenance to Rs. 179 every month. Shah Bano's president went to Supreme Court and filed a petition against the verdict of High Court of Madhya Pradesh. Her husband's essential argument was that after divorce, he cannot keep any form of alliance or connection with his divorced wife, because it is not allowed by Islamic laws and is haram, and hence he is not legally responsible to maintain her wife. Following were the issues raised in the case. First, whether Section 125 of CRPC is concerned with Muslims or not. Second, whether the amount of maintenance given by the husband on divorce is adequate to get the husband rid and is liable to maintain his wife or not. Third, whether uniform civil code applies to all religions or not. Supreme Court gave a like-minded conclusion in the case and banished the plea of Mohammad Ahmad Khan and validated the verdict of High Court. The court held that Section 125 Clause 3 of CRPC solicited to Muslims too, without any sort of discrimination. Supreme Court in this case duly held that since responsibility of Muslim husband towards her divorced wife is limited to the extent of iddat period, even though this situation does not contemplate the rule of law that is mentioned in Section 125 of CRPC. According to the Supreme Court, Muslim law was against humanity or was wrong because here a divorced wife was not in condition to maintain herself. Thus, at the end, after very long procedure, court finally concluded that the husband's legal liability will come to an end if divorced wife is competent to maintain herself. But this situation will be reserved in the case when wife is not in condition to finance or maintain herself after the iddat period. She will be entitled to receive maintenance or alimony under Section 125 of CRPC.